I'm here with the victorious Maryville University juggler, Walrus, and I believe we have a few family members here. Would you guys mind introducing yourselves?
I'm Jeff, I'm his father.
Yeah, my name is Shane, I'm his brother.
All right, thank you guys so much for joining us here. Have you guys been to an esports event before to support Walrus?
We went to the LOL DreamHack in Austin last year where they won it.
C-Star League.
Oh, nice, okay.
At DreamHack Austin, we were there last year.
Okay, very cool. Has it been different here at the LCS studio?
Yeah, it is. It's a little different.
It's a lot bigger.
The stage presence is more unique, more professional, and just kind of neat.
Yeah, absolutely.
Very kind of neat.
Speaking of that that sort of professional edge, Walrus, has it been different playing in front of people on like this big of a stage and this like magnitude of a tournament? I know you guys have played in tournaments before. Has it been different here?
Yeah, most definitely. Playing online, you kind of get more comfortable and everything, but playing on stage is a different level of like nerve smacking, and it's just once you get that first game, you just know what you gotta do for the next game is win. And that's what I'm doing out there and did today.
That's exactly what you guys did. You guys completed a 3-0 sweep of Robert Morris University, and you're heading to the finals tomorrow. How are you feeling about that match tomorrow?
We're feeling really confident. We did really well against them in scrims Tuesday, so I'm looking forward to going into the game really strong.
Now, you had some excellent play on this Gragas jungle pick, and some great body slam flashes, some really strong skirmishes in the early game. I noticed in game two, you were 2-0-2, you were ahead, and you, I see mostly Gragas, especially when I had building Grink Echoes, and I saw you go for Cinderhulk. I wanted to hear what your former thought behind that was.
Well, to be honest with you, I know that right now, like, what's working is a heavy top carry. I mean, top lane carry as, like, Kled, Fiora, etc., or anything. And so I'm kind of sacrificing playmaking to be a tank for our team. So I'm kind of like one of those junglers where my team goes before me, which I'm totally fine with. And so normally I go running geckos, but it's just if I have like a tank top lane, it just matters kind of that. But yeah, it works well to clear.
All right. Well, that makes a lot of sense. Thank you. I'm going to come over to you two guys here, father and brother, right?
Yes.
Especially for you, Jeff, what was this be like?
Well, you have to understand, I don't know if you guys know the situation. I'm originally from Chesterfield, Missouri. I came to California 33 years ago. We get a call 2 years ago from a school, calls me and said, have you heard of Maryville University? I'm like, Kim, that's my hometown. It's not the same school, honey, believe me. She calls me back, she goes, you're not going to believe this, it's Maryville. The chances of that happening, I think we were told it was something like 42 million to one. My hometown would actually pick him to go to his team from Southern California, so it's kind of crazy. And it's beautiful for me to see because Shane is the reason that his younger brother is even playing video games. And Shane's the one, he's 6 years older, and he got him into playing, so he gets all the credit, actually.
So you got him into playing. Did your gaming career start then? Have you played other games competitively, or were you doing any League of Legends tournaments before college?
I did one of those Black Monster Cups. I did some of those in the...
Okay.
I don't know if those tournaments were called Gopher Law or something. Those tournaments
Gopher
before. I did a bunch of those, but he started me on them. He played qualifiers before I did. So it was kind of interesting watching him play.
Okay.
Sojin used to be his jungler. So watching
him
play better than him, I'm like, yeah, I'm better jungler than you. But yeah, it's definitely an awesome feeling having like my brother play it and like learning from him and then becoming a better player from that.
That's really cool. So you have this, like, it's really awesome to see you guys out here in support. Do you guys live out here, or do you guys came out here?
We live in Anaheim Hills, California right now.
Oh, okay.
But we go see him, you know, every few months, and it's beautiful. It's a wonderful thing. It's in L.A. this year, which is, you know, hometown boy comes home and hopefully wins a championship, so.
Yeah, absolutely. Has it been special playing in your hometown? Has it been different?
No, it's definitely. Just playing on the stage where the pros play is like another level. And it's like, I can do this and play at a high level. It's just like, maybe this could be in the future, playing here again. So, yeah, love it.
Absolutely. And this is, yeah, you're on the big stage, like you said. Some people, they tend to struggle. You decided to go and steal a Baron, 1v5 your team in the game. I honestly thought that RMU had that. I thought, okay, 3-1, that seems reasonable, honestly. And that Baron steal is what kept you guys in the late game for Prototype. You go off and you guys win these great late game fights with the Jinx and the Vladimir.
Yeah.
Was that a, like... Did you kind of look around the mini map? Okay, I can do this. I have Legion of it, or was it just kind of like I'm going for
this? I'll be honest with you. My flash had a cooldown of 6 seconds, so I was just walking around letting them miss skill shots, and then as it came up, I flashed in Q smite and died, and I was like, I'm a smite king.
I would love to hear comments from that album for Maryville.
That's going on. That's why my voice is gone.
That's awesome. Again, congratulations.
Thank you.
You just mentioned in terms of, you know, maybe playing here again in the future. Do you have plans to pursue some kind of professional career after college?
I'd like to definitely help. So I mean, I'm definitely gonna, like, after I graduate, definitely look to home, take a year off and maybe see what happens. Maybe during the summer, do a NACS tryout for a sub or anything. I'm looking for anything just to go to the next level and show that I can perform.
Absolutely. Well, thank you all very much for the interview. Is there anything else that you'd like to say to your fans or maybe new fans after that fantastic series?
Thank you guys for all your support and supporting Maryville throughout this whole time. And I'm glad I have my family here to support me, so thank you guys all.
Go Saints!
You can catch Maryville University taking on University of Toronto tomorrow in the finals of the League of Legends College Championship here in Santa Monica. For everything else, esports, you can go to Hala.com.